In this video, I want to show you how to mount an external hard drive or USB key as a folder in Windows 10. I will also explain why this is important in some cases. Let me first explain why this is important in some cases. Let's say you insert a USB key like I'm doing now. And this USB key takes the drive that is F. So if you have an automated task, let's say copying pictures or copying some files to this USB key, and you use the drive letter F, and let's say this drive letter changes for any reason, what we can do to address this is to mount this drive under an empty folder under drive C. This way we can always point to this folder instead of pointing to this drive. So if the drive letter changes from F to I to J to H, the mounted folder stays the same. So let me show you an example. Let me create any file in this folder. Let me create, for instance, a text document, test mount, let's call it. And here, if you go to the command prompt and you say F, so to go to drive F, as you see here, and you launch the command dir, which is a very basic command, you see that you have a file called test mount. Now, if you have a script that is automated and it copies things to F and F disappears, it won't be able to do it. So to mount this drive as a folder under your C drive, you need to launch a program called Disk Manager. There are many ways to launch it. I'm gonna show you two ways to launch it because Windows sometimes changes the way it launches programs. So the first one, which is the easiest one, is go to the search box and type Disk Manager. And you see it is here. Just click on it, it will open. Another way to launch it is to go to your computer. So under Explorer, right click this PC, click Manage here, and then you find under Storage the Disk Management add-in here. So now let's continue our work. In this example, this is the F drive that I'm gonna be addressing also as a mounted folder. To do this, right-click it, select Change Drive Letter and Path, keep the drive letter, and click on Add, and here you should mount it always in an empty NTFS folder. So click on Browse, choose the C drive, and under C drive, either you choose an empty folder or you create a new empty folder. Let's create a new empty folder and call it Mounted Drive. You can call it whatever you want. And here, just click OK. Click OK again. And if you go now to C, go back to the root folder, and CD mounted drive, you see that you have the mounted drive here. If you perform the action dir, you see that it's always here. Now I'm gonna show you, if I change the drive letter of this USB drive, that it won't be accessible under F anymore, but it will always be accessible under C mounted drive. So let's do this now. So right click on the partition, change drive letter. Let's change the F. Put it anything that is available. Let's put it on J. Okay, it will give you a warning. Yes, yes again. And you see now it opened under J. So now here, if you go to F, it will give you an error that this drive doesn't exist. But you still have the C mounted drive. So let's go to the root folder. And if you go to J, it will work, of course. F, it will not work. But C, CD mounted drive, it will always work. So your patch file or your automated task will always work. Let me show you this in Explorer now, how it looks. So in Explorer, you have always your J drive that it is here, but under C also you have this mounted drive which was automatically created, and this is true for any user that logs on to this PC. If you double click on it, it's here, and you see here is the pass. So that was it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it, and if you did, I would appreciate it if you subscribe to my channel and give this video a thumbs up. Thank you for watching.